So, good morning, everyone. I want first to thank the organizer of this meeting for inviting me and giving you the occasion to present the work we have done on RNA-seq sequencing with the MinION system. And at the Ibenz Genomics Facility, what we want is to help our researchers with high-throughput sequencing technologies from experimental data design towards data analysis. And we are a member of the France Genomic Consortium, which gathers several genomic facilities in France. And we are mostly dedicated to functional genomics analysis in eukaryotes. And as you can see here on the pie chart, most of our library preparations are dedicated to RNA-seq. This is the reason why we were interested in the MinION system, because we would be able to get full-length transcripts with sequencing. And to do that, we use validation models based on mouse peripheral nervous system developments, where we compare wild-type mice against knockout mice for the transcription factor CROX20, which is involved in the myelination process. So first of all, we set up a computational infrastructure in order to perform the MinION analysis, and we did several tests. First of all, we benchmark threads optimization each time a new version of AlbaCore is available, and we also spend time to see that working with solid-state disk is really, really better when you want to do bas calling with 1D square sequencing results. Next, we also set up a software called TuliQC to work on the quality control dedicated to RNA-seq analysis, and with the idea behind to retrieve information more dedicated to RNA, which is the distribution of transcript lengths, and also the barcoding, the barcode distribution against samples, which is really interesting, and I will go on further later. For the moment, TuliQC is working with AlbaCore version 2 and will soon be available when with 1D square. As Nick Lohmann told you before, we are we think that reproducible is very important when you want to launch a software. This is why, first, you can access the open source code on our GitHub repository, and also you can use the software using Docker images. Then, the first thing is that we want to test for barcoding influence on the sequencing throughput. This is why we compare two samples, so the same wild-type samples, and we barcoded one part of the samples, and we sequence without barcode the other part. What we get here is that you can see that whatever the flow cell we use and the chemistry we use, we don't see any significant differences on the yield with barcoding compared to without barcodes. So we go further in the analysis by mapping reads against ensemble CDNA references, and we do that using the EULSAN workflow we set up for all the RNA-seq analysis we performed. And what we see when we look at the most expressed transcripts is that for barcoded samples, we retrieve myelin protein 0, MPZ, which is involved in the myelination process, whereas without barcodes, we retrieve ribosomal RNA or housekeeping genes. So for the moment, I have not clear explanation why we get that. It's just that it seems that when we barcode samples, we get more analyzable results with barcoding information. So then we move to the validation data analysis we want to perform. So we compare our two conditions, wild types against knockout mice, and we do triplicates experiments for both conditions. And starting with 100 nanograms of total RNA, we use the cDNA kit in order to perform several runs using R9 flow cells and R9.4 flow cells and 2D and 1D chemistry. What we see is a constant improvement in yield, and now we are able to achieve 5.6 million reads on average using the 1D chemistry on R9.4 flow cell. If we go through the data analysis, first, we mapped, we test several mappers to map these reads on the reference genome. So we compare BWA, GraphMap, GMAP, and Minimap2. And what we get, and I show you here the visualization on a genome browser of one transcript, is that we get a much more homogeneous coverage using Minimap2 compared to BWA. You see that some, for example, here exons are missing, and also a more homogeneous coverage compared to the first lane, which is Illumina NextX results. And it allows us to retrieve two times more read counts using Minimap2. We then go through the differential analysis using DSeq2 and HT-Seqons for counting transcripts, and we were able to retrieve more than 6,500 differentially expressed genes using an adjusted p-value of 1%, and 300,000 1D unique alignments by sample. Which is really interesting is that 86 of these differentially expressed transcripts are conserved when we compare to the NextSeq results we already obtained doing Perrin 150 sequencing. And that if we look at the correlation we get using ranking log2 fold change, we see that most of the transcripts are correlated, and we can retrieve interesting targets who get a high rank using the MinION systems compared to a lower rank with Illumina. So we are still investigating for the moment. With these results, we can also work on splicing event detection. So we do that in collaboration with the Genosplice company located in Paris. So we sent us our Illumina results. They work on their pipeline and get us back a list of splicing events. And in this list, we mine for the results we can get in the Oxford Nanopore data. And we can detect things that they found in Illumina. And we also detect a differentially expressed exon expression between wild type compared to knockout genes. So, to conclude, we are able now to work with the MinION in a very automated way. We achieve very good yield with the 1D chemistry. We were able to go up to 10 million reads using the R9.4 flow cells. We don't see any visible influence of the barcoding procedure, so we are now barcoding all our samples systematically. And we were able to achieve, to perform differential analysis with as low as 100,000 reads, so lower number of alignments. For the moment, so we are working on testing how 1D square can help us working with RNA-seq analysis. We want to work with lower amount of starting material because in our institute, people working in development and neuroscience, and we are very limited in the number of starting material we can get. And we are also still working with Genosplice on how we can perform better isoform detections with our results. So all this work has been done by the team of the facility. So people working in the biology part, Amara Mohamad for the test of the MinION with the help of Corinne Blujon and Cédric Fund, and also Fanny Coulpier. And for the bioinformatics parts, Laurent Jourdran for the development of the software, Sophie Lemoine for the data analysis, with the help of Lionel Ferrato, Aurélien Birer, and Bérangère Lafay. So if you are interested, you can follow us on Twitter and reach us with our website. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Stéphane. Again, we have time for a couple questions specific to the talks. If you have some more general ones, let's save them for the end. So wait for the microphone. We have one in the back over there, Margie.
Have you done any looking at fusions between genes and trying to detect them with the reads?
Not for the moment. In the experimental design we are looking at, I'm not sure to expect fusion genes. It should be, for the moment, considered as false positive, or I don't working really on detecting the fusion genes.
So do you think your software would work on that? Would you have to modify the software to detect fusions?
In my opinion, there is already software available, for example, in cancer analysis, who are looking to fusion transcripts. So perhaps you can use it, because once you have done bas calling and mapping, finally you are ending with something which is quite similar to other kind of sequencing process.
Do we have one more question? Yeah. Just wait a second, Martin.
Did you do PCR-based barcoding, or is it native ligation barcoding?
If I correct, it's PCR-based barcoding. We don't do that for the moment for the cDNA PCR-free kit. We will do it, but for the moment, if I'm correct, barcoding is not available for the cDNA PCR-free kit. But if it's possible, I will test it.
Thank you very much, Stéphane.